Welcome to Minity Maths. In this video, we'll cover what you need to know about angles, from the basics to more advanced concepts. We'll start by looking at the different types of angles, then move on to essential angle rules and facts. After that, we'll explore angles in parallel lines and finish with interior and exterior angles. Whether you're revising for a test or just want to strengthen your understanding, this video has you covered. Let's get started. An angle is a measure of rotation and can be measured in degrees, which is represented by this symbol. Here are some examples. Angles are often labeled in relation to the line segments that they are between. Points are labeled with letters. We can also use these symbols when we are referring to angles. However, for simplicity, we often use single letters or symbols such as these to label an angle. There are different types of angles. Acute angles are angles which are greater than 0 and less than 90 degrees. A right angle measures exactly 90 degrees and the angle is indicated by a square rather than a curve. An obtuse angle is an angle greater than 90 degrees and less than 180 degrees. A straight angle is equal to 180 degrees and lies upon a straight line. A reflex angle is greater than 180 degrees but less than 360 degrees. A full rotation measures exactly 360 degrees. Next, we have two sets of questions to test your knowledge. Have a go at the first set of practice questions and pause the video while you work them out. Now have a go at these questions and state the type of angle. So, let's have a look at some of the basic rules. The first of these rules to remember is that angles in a triangle add up to 180 degrees. This is true for any triangle. We can use this fact to work out problems similar to this one, where we have to find the missing angle. Now rearrange the equation to find the answer. Another rule is that angles in a quadrilateral, a shape with four sides, will always add up to 360 degrees. We can see this is true because we can divide the shape into two triangles, and each triangle has angles totaling 180 degrees. Let's solve this question by using this rule. Again, we can rearrange the equation to find the angle. The next rule is that angles on a straight line will always add up to 180 degrees. Have a look at this example. The next rule is that angles around a point add up to 360 degrees. Here is an example of a question which we can solve using this fact. When we have two straight lines which cross, the angles vertically opposite each other, at the vertex, are equal. Here angles A and C are equal, and angles B and D are equal. Let's look at this example question. D is vertically opposite to the 143 degree angle, therefore D is also 143 degrees. We can also calculate angle A, knowing the rule that angles on a straight line add up to 180 degrees. Finally, as angle C is vertically opposite the 37 degree angle, it is also equal to 37 degrees. Have a go at this practice question to put into practice the angle rules you have learnt. Parallel lines are lines which run alongside each other, and will never intersect. Parallel lines will usually be indicated by arrows on the lines. If there is more than one pair of parallel lines, then these will be indicated with more than one arrow. When a line crosses two parallel lines, special angles are formed in which there are particular names and properties. Angles that are opposite each other are always equal. Notice that the two angles labeled A are equal, and the two angles labeled B are equal. These are called opposite angles, or more informally, X angles. These angles can also exist without a pair of parallel lines. Here is an example. Alternate angles are found on alternate sides of the line that crosses the pair of parallel lines, a transversal. These angles are always equal and are within a Z shape. However, the Z shape doesn't always look like a conventional Z, so these are ones to watch out for. Let's have a look at this example. Corresponding angles are also equal, and these can be found within an F shape. Note that the F can also be facing backwards. Now let's look at this example. Allied angles are angles which can be found within a C or U shape. These angles always add up to 180 degrees. Again, the C shape can actually be backwards. Here is an example. Have a go at these questions, pause the video while you figure them out, and try to note down the explanations of how you calculated each angle. In this final part of the video, we are going to cover interior and exterior angles of polygons. We will explain how to calculate interior and exterior angles, how to find the sum of those angles, and how to find the number of sides of a polygon, given an angle. Practice questions and answers are provided at the end of the video. Firstly, let's look at this polygon. Here we have an interior angle, which is inside the shape. And here we have an exterior angle. Exterior angles are outside of the shape. The interior and exterior angle will form a straight line. Let's start by looking at interior angles. Here we have a triangle. The triangle is a very important shape when calculating the sum of the interior angles of a polygon. The most important thing to note is that the interior angles of a triangle will always add up to 180 degrees. Now let's look at this square. Notice that we can split the square up into two triangles exactly. We can use our knowledge of the interior angles of a triangle to calculate the sum of the interior angles of this square. As we have two triangles inside this square, the sum of the interior angles will equal two lots of 180 degrees. Next, we have an irregular pentagon in which we can split into three triangles. Therefore, the sum of the interior angles will be equal to three lots of 180 degrees. Here we have a hexagon which can be split into four triangles. So the interior angles will add up to four lots of 180 degrees. Have you noticed a pattern here? Well, the number of triangles which can perfectly fit inside any polygon will always be equal to two less than the number of sides of that polygon. This allows us to create a formula which we can use to calculate the sum of the interior angles for any polygon. The sum of the interior angles equals n minus 2 times 180 degrees, where n is the number of sides. Have a look at this example. Using this knowledge, we can also calculate each individual interior angle, as long as the shape is a regular polygon, where all angles will be equal. We do this by dividing our answer, for the sum of interior angles, by the number of angles or sides of that shape. For example, as this is a five-sided shape, we can divide 540 degrees by 5. Therefore, each angle of a pentagon is 108 degrees. Now let's look at exterior angles. The important point to remember is that the exterior angles of any polygon will always add up to 360 degrees. Additionally, if we know the interior angle, we can calculate the exterior by using the angles on a straight line fact. This is, that angles on a straight line will always add up to 180 degrees. Therefore, we can take the interior angle away from 180 to find the value of the exterior angle. Finally, for regular polygons only, we can find the number of sides of that polygon by dividing 360 by the value of the exterior angle. This will tell us how many angles there are, as well as the amount of sides. Now have a go at these practice questions. Pause the video whilst you work them out. Thanks for watching Minity Maths.